Welcome to Aerodynamics in Minutes. In this video, we are going to see the different types of drag. There are three types of drag. There are parasitic drag, induced drag, and wave drag. Parasitic drag is classified into three types. They are form drag, interference drag, and skin friction drag. Form drag is due to the shape of the object, which affects the aerodynamic properties of the object. As you can see, the flow gets separated in the plate. This causes turbulence and increases the drag. Even though the airfoil and the plate has the same area, the plate produces more drag due to its shape. Interference drag comes from the intersection of air stream that creates turbulence or restricts smooth air flow. For example, the streamline was disturbed by the first airfoil and the second airfoil increases drag and will not work as expected due to the disturbance in the streamline created by the first airfoil. Skin friction drag is created by the actual contact of air particles against the surface of aircraft. This is same as the friction between any two objects in the real world. Induced drag is the drag generated due to the lift. As you can see, the lift force is not vertical. It is inclined at some angle. Therefore, drag force increases with increase in angle of attack. As the angle of attack increases, the flow separation also increases. Wing tip varices comes under the induced drag. The high pressure underneath the wing causes the airflow at the tip of the wing to curl around from bottom to top in a circular motion. These vertices reduces the effective area ratio. The wing tip varices increases as the angle of attack increases. Since the pressure difference between the top and bottom surface of the wing increases with increase in angle of attack, the magnitude of the induced drag can be found out using the formula: coefficient of induced drag is equal to coefficient of lift square divided by pi e into area ratio. Let's come to wave drag. As we all know, the flow gets accelerated on top of the airfoil. If the velocity of the flow reaches a sonic or a bosonic condition, the shock wave is produced. It can be oblique shock or normal shock, and there will be sudden increase in drag due to the shock. This sudden increase in drag due to the shock is called wave drag. This is Dianish, signing off in Aerodynamics in Minutes. See you in the next video. Stay tuned.